Hi, welcome to the DevOps Lab. This episode, we have Deepak and Michael. What are we going to be talking about, guys?
Hey, today we're going to talk about the real-world scenario testing and availability measurement using Azure DevOps pipeline.
Awesome. Super exciting. Tune in. Hi, welcome to the DevOps Lab. On this episode, we have as our guest, Michael and Deepak. How are you guys doing?
Great.
So what do you guys do at Microsoft?
So I'm a developer in Azure, where we work on a project called Cloud Collaboration Center. Mm-hmm. And we have visualization applications where we are doing lately a scenario-based testing using Azure Devs Pipeline.
Okay.
And I want to talk about that and share how we do that and how we increase the availability in our application.
Very cool. And Michael?
Yeah, I'm also a software engineer in Deepak's team and working on the Azure Cloud Collaboration Center as well. So yeah, happy to be here.
Very cool. So one problem that we're facing in today's world, right, is availability. Our apps and our sites need to be up all the time, 24/7. They cannot go down because every second they're down, people are losing money. But the problem that we face is how do we know when our site's down, right? We can wait until our customer calls us, but that's way too late. So you two have a way of doing availability testing using Azure Pipeline, is that correct?
That's right.
Awesome, why don't you show us what you guys have?
Yeah, sure. So I'll give a little bit of context of adding to what Abel was mentioning. In an Azure PaaS context, right, like web apps, when you're running on Azure, using Azure App Services, there lot of times you have that ping test, seeing that your site is available, right? That is the basic test, and it can get you that far in terms of measuring the availability of your endpoints, right? But more often, you run into issues which is beyond platform, and like app service has anyway high availability. They have SLA of like 3 nines or 4 nines. So your ping test is most likely to be passed most of the times.
Right.
Where the testing or the availability drops is in the scenarios and how your different features are operating in real time.
So for instance, it would be something like, you know, great, my site is up,
yes,
but if I try to fill out this form and hit post, bam, my site crashes.
Exactly.
That's what we're looking for, right?
Right, that's what. So it's like end-to-end scenario where from the user interaction and the transaction is done, right? So that is more functional. And there are a lot of the more bigger application you have, the more business you're doing over there. Mm-hmm. Like there are more interactions and there is a lot of user interfacing, right? So you want to test that in real time, often like again and again, and that measure the availability, what we call scenario testing, and then measure how much time it is available, right, over a period of time.
Right.
So that's the gist of it. And how we do that is basically, Michael is going to show the demo in a minute, but I'll just explain at high level. What we do is we leverage. So we have written a good amount of end-to-end test, the UI test, which does all transactions or all the user actions as our users we would expect, and then so exercising the whole interaction.
Got it. Right? So these would be automated UI tests?
Automated UI test. And we use Selenium WebDriver to do that. Perfect. With Visual Studio and C Sharp. And so that is there, right? Now, we typically, when you have those end-to-end tests and UI tests, you run as part of your build and CI/CD.
Sure.
So that is there in place, but we take it to the next level where we said, let's not only during the build and deployment, why don't we run it on a frequent intervals, like say every 5 minutes, and say, using the same infrastructure as we have for our CI/CD, using Azure Pipeline, let's build another pipeline and run this test every 5 minutes or 15 minutes, right? Based on how frequently we want to run, and even categorize them as priority one and priority two, so that P1s or the high priority we run every 5 minutes, the others we can run like in 15 minutes and so, and then see, leverage the DevOps test analytics, mm-hmm. right, to see the test results,
yeah.
so that you can see right there. Or then he'll talk more about what are the sort of some of the limitations of that, and then we move to using Azure DevOps API mm-hmm. to pull those numbers of wow. test results yeah. and then compute the availability.
Yeah.
And then even we took it further with how can we use App Insights and use that further. So
wow.
with that rich data, mm-hmm. we have like every 5 minutes, our like 30 to 50 UI test yeah. runs every minute, mm-hmm. every 5 minutes or 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And then we get rich data, mm-hmm. and then we can compute availability. Out of this many tests,
yeah.
these were passed and these are failed. Yeah. This directly relates to how our users are experiencing the application.
That sounds unbelievably cool, right?
Yeah.
I just thought you guys were just going to ping the page or something, but this
yeah.
is like really end-to-end testing on a schedule and gathering that data and correlating
right.
it and everything, right?
Right.
Man, I'd love to see this.
Yeah, and one more thing I will yeah. add before giving to Michael
sure.
is we run sort of it as a runner.
Mm-hmm.
We are running, right, and testing and using Azure DevOps pipeline as an infrastructure to run that. But many times that Azure DevOps pipeline running on a hosted VM, right, or a mm-hmm. hosted agent, that is running from one location, say US West or somewhere in Europe, where your pipeline is hosted. But your users may be coming around the world, right?
Right.
So
right.
How do you, so the way we look, the way we do that is basically have a custom agent in mm-hmm. different locations, right?
Oh.
And then yeah. have that custom agent part of the Azure pipeline.
Oh,
so that way
clever.
We can run this from different places.
Awesome, awesome.
Cool.
And then I'll have Michael talk about and show the demo.
Yeah. So basically the setup for this is quite simple.
Mm-hmm.
We have the separate test definitions for each of the basic categories that we want to test, the
okay.
scenarios that we want to test.
Okay.
For instance, center wall, left wall, and right wall is our scenarios for our case.
Okay.
And basically how we set it up is just what we want to do is build the solution for the end-to-end test and basically run it
okay.
with the test category. So it runs through each of the test cases within that test category
okay.
that's set in our project.
Mm-hmm.
So a typical test case would involve, it will look something like this. For this, it's running for our map test.
Okay.
And our map view is basically, it looks something like this, and
cool.
as you can see, there's quite a lot of things going on.
Right.
So there's these circles, which is called the DDoS bubbles for us,
mm-hmm.
and basically we're testing each values in the DDoS bubble itself to see if they're there or not. So
okay.
like the geos and the numbers itself,
mm-hmm.
we're testing that. And there's also the flashcards in each of the maps, and for each of the flashcards, we test the details inside the flashcard itself. So it's very extensive, and each of our test cases basically covers a lot of things. So if it does succeed, we are fairly confident that the site is up and running, and you know we're fairly confident that the users are not seeing any issues.
Right.
So it's actually a meaningful number if it's 100%. So
mm-hmm.
that's why we want to keep track of during our scrums or anything, we
mm-hmm.
want to keep track of our test results for the past day and see if anything wrong is going on or something, and then we can act on it before other users sees the issue.
Very nice.
And we also set up alerting along the way if a test does fail, and so it will send us alert, and we know before the customer himself sees that issue.
Perfect.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, so the page is very dynamic,
so
it's real-time updates, so we want to make sure the correct data is flowing through
right.
and the elements which we expect users to interact with are available on the page.
Very, very cool. So yeah. quick question before you go
yeah.
on, how do you set up these real-time alerts? Is it through
yeah.
Azure DevOps?
We have internally the alert system,
okay.
the incident management system inside Microsoft, which we leverage.
Mm-hmm.
So it's using the webhook and using the runbook and Azure automation.
Mm-hmm.
We set up that through App Insights.
Got it.
So App Insight using alert in the Azure Monitor and App Insight suite,
mm-hmm.
we leverage that.
Got it. Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect. Perfect.
So this is the Basically, this is what we initially used to get the test analytics for day to day. This is built in by Azure DevOps. And while it does a lot of things well, it shows a lot of data every single day. And within the past 30 days, it also shows you what test has failed within that time span. However, there's some limitation that it has, and that is mainly that we don't have custom start and end date for filtering purposes. So most of our use case would be something like, we want to see what test has failed in the past day or past 3 days. Basically, if you're coming in on Monday and you want to see what happened over the weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday and Monday as well. So this really, like, if this the filter is at best 7 days, and if there's some tests that failed 5 days ago, and then there's some tests that failed 1 or 2 days ago, you don't really know like which test failed on which day. And the only way to deal with that is to click on each of the tests and then to see when it failed. So it's kind of troublesome for the DRIs and also for us to, you know, in Scrums to quickly show like which test has failed this day. So that's one issue that we found that we want to solve. And another is that this build build definitions, they have a retention policy of like on default is like 30 days or something. So as you can see here, it's usually keep for 30 days. So we have some scenarios where we want to find the data before that. For instance, for some PAM review or something, we want to compare the last month's numbers to the last month's numbers. And we couldn't achieve that with calling the Azure DevOps API. Also, the last thing is that using the Azure DevOps API, this is one of the examples of their data. And as you can see, it has everything except for things like why the test has failed. And you know, of course, this it's they don't have a way to like include the logs. Or, there's no logs to this specific test case and why it failed. So
it's just it just says
it, it just says it failed. But for the DRI himself, he have to drill down into that built definition itself and go through the logs to see why it has failed. So we want to include that level of information in, all in one place. So that is the biggest motivation of why we went with the just dumping every result into the App Insights. And so basically one of our queries would, the end result would look something like this. So it will, this is the last.
So hold on a second, because I just want to make sure I'm understanding this correctly. All right. So because of the limitations inside of Azure DevOps and the way they present the data, what you guys are doing now is on a timer or something like that, you're running your tests, and then you're grabbing all that data and sending it on over to App Insights.
So a little tweak to that. Basically, every test when it runs, we instead of doing outside, we did as part of the test. So test will log the results, and if it fails, why it failed, right? So every test is logging the pass and fail in App Insights.
Okay, so, your tests are logging all the information to App Insights.
Yes.
Okay, perfect.
And so this is an example of a log from the test results. And these are all the test results that failed recently. So it has other information like the error message itself, and the stack trace even is included, so that you can see like the line numbers and whatnot.
That. That's the most important thing for me.
And it also has the URL where it failed, basically, which page did it try to go to when it failed. So yeah, with this, we built our custom dashboard. And basically, what we want to do is. So basically what we want to do is have a way for us to be able to just quickly see like what's the availability like for the past day. And it's taking.
So this dashboard, is it pulling the data from Application Insight?
Exactly.
Ah,
right.
Okay.
And this is the last leg of the equation where we're saying measuring the availability.
Yes.
Right. And yep. This is all coming through that. Like now we have like out of how many tests run, mm-hmm. like in this time range, all of them passed in the category where he showed about the build definition around these category.
Yeah.
This is the availability we have, and this is the latency of how much time it took.
Very cool. This is a custom dashboard.
This is a custom dashboard, right. And right. As I would emphasize one thing is, this is more, in our scenario, we needed that as Michael mentioned, there mm-hmm. were some limiting factors,
sure.
but for many teams, it may be like 7 days or 30 days, and test analytics page on yeah. DevOps is sufficient,
enough, right?
Or API yeah. is good enough, right?
Yeah.
So we actually started that, used it for many months, mm-hmm. and then we found us limiting as our scope was increasing. So we went up with this solution.
Very, very cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
And as you can see, you can drill down. This is all App Insight data. Now you can say why it is 99.8, because these tests failed at this time.
Oh. Cool.
So that's cool. another way to look at it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then he briefly mentioned on this data,
yeah.
We have alert set up as yeah. we talk about using mm-hmm. Azure Monitor
right.
and automation and runbook.
Yeah.
And then it like wakes up and bring to our notification and attention that something is going wrong.
All right, so this has been amazing information. Let me recap just to make sure I understand this correctly,
yeah.
right? All right, so you guys are using Azure Pipelines to basically kick off automated UI tests against your site.
Exactly.
On a schedule, right?
On a schedule, yeah.
And then in your tests, you're logging that information, pass or fail, or maybe just the failure, but okay. you're passing all that information that is gathering during your test to Application Insight.
That's right.
Then, using Application Insight, you can create alerts in case your site's down or things like that.
Right.
And also, you built another site that pulls the data from Application Insight and displays the availability times inside of it.
Exactly.
Man, that's some really cool stuff.
Cool.
Yeah, exciting, exciting stuff. Thank you both so much for sharing this. This is fascinating stuff. So developers out there, or whoever's involved, call to action, go to dev.azure.com, create an Azure DevOps account, and start playing around with this, right? Using Azure Pipelines, build out some automated UI test and do it on a timer. Will your code and
yeah.
things like that be available soon?
Yeah, definitely. We'll be putting as part of the video.
Awesome, awesome. So it will be in a UR link down somewhere there, maybe? We'll have the link available for you guys. Thank you all so much. Thank you, viewers, and join us next time.
Thank you.